Hi, my name is Mike Benjamin. I lead the CenturyLink Threat Research Labs team. Our team aims to understand internet threats through the use of data from our global network. We utilize this information to share with the broader security community, as well as other internet service providers, and to use to mitigate the threats and reduce the risk for our customers. Today, we are releasing a botnet research report that we're hoping can be utilized in order to minimize the risk and help companies and consumers be more proactive in their security posture. The first key takeaway from the threat report is that our Threat Research Labs team has been tracking 195,000 average daily threats across the global internet. Those hosts have interacted with and caused 104 million victims across the global internet. Our second key takeaway from the threat report relates to the DDoS botnets Mirai and Gafgit. So as you read through news headlines, you'll find a lot of information focused on Mirai and its various derivatives over the last couple of years. And while the botnet has posed a risk to the internet, it's interesting to see the lack of information related to the Gafgit botnet. Mirai is often listed under other names as well. Think names like Satori, Masuta, Okiru, variants that have been named by the actors, but really aren't a large derivative on the original Mirai source code. Conversely, Gafgit has posed a more significant threat than you would think by reading news headlines. We've actually seen more Gafgit attacks and longer attacks launched by Gafgit-related DDoS botnets over the last year. The last key takeaway from the threat report relates to the Mirai and Gafgit botnets. Now, it's well known that they are popular due to their open source nature, where any actor can download the source code. But what's less known is how long these threats may last within the global internet. Here at CenturyLink, we have taken action to reduce the risk to our customers and to our network. However, for the global community, they do pose a long-term risk in some cases. We've also listed some information that may be of interest related to the various volumes of what attack types are used. This can be used by companies and businesses in order to decide how they may protect themselves against DDoS attacks. Here at CenturyLink, we believe it's important for businesses and consumers to understand how botnets can impact the technology that they use on a daily basis. We also believe that the security community needs to take a more proactive approach to removing these threats from the internet. We are doing that through sharing this information here with you, as well as proactively mitigating these threats within our global backbone. If you'd like to hear more about CenturyLink and its security solutions, please visit our website.